Okay, so in this tutorial, I'll show you how you can get started with using InTrack Studio. We'll have a look at what kind of hardware setup you need to use the program effectively, and how to wire everything up so you can start recording your songs. So let's begin. If you're aiming at a professional or even a decent, clear recording quality, it's probably best to record audio via an external audio interface. For those of you just starting with music production, an audio interface is an external device with which you can connect your instruments or microphones to record vocals or instruments or whatever else into your computer. Generally, it allows you to record at a higher quality and fidelity than any computer's built-in microphone, usually by connecting it to your laptop or desktop computer via a USB cable. Although using an external device is generally a good idea, you can also start recording your music without one, therefore using your built-in audio input. If this is the case and you don't see an audio input on your device, you should know that some computers, especially laptop models, only offer one audio output for headphones. These outputs usually allow for a microphone to be connected in as well via a splitter cable. So let's take a look at how to set up an external audio interface, in this case via a USB connection, and how to get InTrack ready to receive and record audio from it. To connect your audio device, plug your cable into the USB output, then connect it to a USB slot on your Mac or PC. Some audio interfaces require their own drivers in order to work with your computer. If this is the case, make sure you have these installed before you proceed. Once you have your interface set up, launch InTrack Studio. The program will scan your computer in search of connected devices, so if InTrack recognizes your interface, it will select it automatically and allow you to immediately start using it. You can also manually select an external device by navigating to Settings, Audio Devices, and selecting your sound card as an input source. If everything went well, you should start seeing InTrack's input level meter move as your mic picks up sound. To hear your project's audio, connect your headphones or speakers to the sound card's output. If instead you're using the built-in output, connect your headphones to that. You may also choose to record via your sound card, but playback through your built-in output. In this case, make sure you selected these as input and output devices in the Audio Devices dialog accessible via the Settings menu over here. Now that you have your hardware ready, let's have a look at how to record. First of all, plug your jack into one of your interface's available inputs. If you have monitors or speakers connected, it's a good practice to mute or turn these off before inserting the jack to avoid unpleasant noises. Now that we're ready for capturing audio, let's enable our audio track for recording inside InTrack. Click on the arm button on the track's colored bar. This will open a small drop-down where you can select the audio input you wish to record. Okay, so in the next tutorial, we'll be taking a look at how to set up your InTrack project to actually start recording.